Already studied the electronic configuration. Next, atomic size as well as ionization energy. Clear? So, group 13 consists of how many elements in it? Group 13 or guest elements idav? Is it audible for you? Okay, so group 13 consists of 5 elements in it, that is boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, where boron is a non-metal, aluminium is a metal but it has a similar properties to that of a boron, whereas gallium, indium and thallium are again metals here. Means in an group 13, boron is a non-metal while others are metals. We have studied its occurrence. Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, they exist in a combined state. Boron forms as orthoboric acid, borax and kernite, clear, whereas aluminium exists as bauxite ore and cryolite. Boron, it exists in two isotopic forms, which are those? Boron 10 and boron 11 it is, where boron 11 is more common. Means it is present around, its abundance is more around 81%, whereas boron 10 19%. So after the occurrence we started with the physical properties. Among those physical properties, our first physical property was electronic configuration, where the electronic configuration of a group 13 element, means the general electronic configuration of group 13 elements is NS2 NP1, clear, where S is completely filled and P contains only one electrons in it. So it is from boron to thallium, the outermost shell, it has a general configuration of NS2 and NP1. So after the electronic configuration, we studied about the atomic size. As we know, the general trend of an atomic size is top to bottom, the atomic size should go on. Top to bottom atomic size in agree. It should be increased, clear, because the electron enters into different main energy shell, the atomic size will increases from boron to thallium. But an exception occurs in an group 13 elements. What is an exception? The size of gallium is smaller compared to the aluminium kintanu gallium size enadanta smaller. When the size of gallium is smaller compared to an aluminium, this occurs due to the poor screening effect of which orbital? D orbital. Now tell me, why does the nucleus doesn't have attraction towards the, means it has doesn't have screening effect towards the d orbitals? Adaratini d orbitals kade nucleus it poor attraction yakirtad. Why not with s and p? Because the structure of d and f orbitals are large, means they are diffused structure, bahala doddu structure irudrinda nucleus en madangila d matte f olagiruvanta electrons na attract madangila. Instead of that, it will attract the electrons present in s and p orbitals, hence it take it towards itself, because of which the atomic size decreases for gallium compared to the aluminium. Gallium with aluminium na compare madidra gallium with size small irtada, aluminium quite larger. So based on this, again we studied the ionization energy. So general trend top to bottom, the ionization energy increases or decreases? Decreases, because the atomic size increases. Atomic size increase adanga ionization energy ina kontoptha kadmi akontoptha, but mattile exception aagthada yakandre gallium size in itile small adu. When gallium size is smaller, it will be having high ionization energy than that of aluminium. So top to bottom ionization energy kadmi akont barbekagitta, but ada aluminium mat gallium olage enagibittada gallium ionization energy high irthada compared to an aluminium. Again, this is due to the poor screening effect of where? D orbitals. Then what is an inert pair effect? Inert pair effect. First class it kya the nam? Yaudo orbital valgiru anta? Yeah. The reluctance of s electrons during the bonding process, s orbital valgiru anta electrons bonding valg involve aglilandra. Now I effect again and kariti vi inert pair effect. Clear? So first was electronic configuration, second atomic size, and third was the ionization energy. Now we are going to study about the fourth one, and the fourth is electronegativity. So now tell me, what is an electronegativity? What is an electronegativity? Very good. It is a tendency of an atom or ion to gain a electrons. So atom athwa ion electron togoluvanta tendency itta antandra, hence we name such elements as an electronegative elements. So here electronegativity, it again depends upon the atomic size, as we studied in the periodic properties. Now if the atomic size is larger, nucleus is having less or more attraction towards the incoming electron. If the atomic size is larger, it has a less attraction. Size doddidittu andre olag baruvanta electrons kade nucleus ide less attraction irutade. In such a case, electronegativity increases or decreases? Electronegativity decreases. Electron tagulu capacity size heng increase aakkont hogtadla hange enagakat birtidanta decrease aagtade. So here now, according to the general trend, as the atomic size increases, so general trend prakarana ven helabodu, with the increase in atomic size, what happens to the electronegativity? With increase in the atomic size, the nucleus has less attraction towards the incoming electron. Hence, the electronegativity, less attraction under electronegativity decrease. Hence, the electronegativity decreases from boron to thallium. So according to general trend, we can state that with increase in the atomic size, from top to bottom, as the atomic size increases, the nucleus will be having less attraction towards the incoming electron, because of which the electronegativity decreases from boron to thallium. But again, as we know, there is an exception. Matal exception other, what is an exception? Inhood. Now tell me, according to general trend, out of aluminium and gallium, so how they are arranged? It is like this: boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. So top to bottom electronegativity enagatiti decrease akot baratad andre nan normally exception helbetri. Hanga new study madidaga aluminium matte gallium olaga yavudu bhaala electronegative irthada, which is more electronegative? General trend, aluminium is more electronegative, whereas gallium should be less electronegative. This is according to the general trend, but this doesn't occur because, as we know, there is an exception. The exception is within gallium and aluminium, where gallium's atomic size is, it is smaller compared to the aluminium. Now, which is more electronegative if you compare the atomic size? Gallium is more electronegative. Clear? So, in exception, in an exception, gallium is more electro या नेगेटिव दंडी एल्युमिनियम ड्यू टू दी why it is having why it is more electronegative due to the smallest atomic size of gallium which is occurring because of poor screening effect of d orbitals. So due to the poor screening effect, here there is a decrease in the atomic size of an gallium. As there is a decrease in the atomic size of an gallium, it has more attraction towards the incoming electron. So gallium is more electronegative than the aluminium. Clear? So this is about the electronegativity. Here the electronegativity is directly dependent upon the atomic size. Smaller the atomic size, greater or lesser the electronegativity? Greater the electronegativity. But if the atomic size is larger, less will be its electronegativity. Whereas our next property is oxidation state. Now as you know, when it comes to the P block elements, the elements will exhibit variable oxidation state. Now group 13 is under P block, means again it will show. So group 13 elements exhibit variable oxidation state. Clear? Group 13 elements, they exhibit variable oxidation state. Now in the introduction class of P block elements, we have studied about the oxidation state. Now tell me, which is the group oxidation state of a group 13? Group oxidation state of group 13 elements is? It is +3. Why it is +3? In a group oxidation state, the electrons present in which orbitals? NS as well as NP, means NS2 and NP1 are involved in the bonding process. Hence, we get the group oxidation state as +3. Whereas, which are the other oxidation states shown by the group 13 elements? Very good. +1 and -5. So now tell me, why we get +1 oxidation state? P participate madangila. Andrali enadagalle +1 bartada. Which effect is undergoing over there? Due to the inert pair effect, where there is a reluctance of s electron during the bonding process, only the electrons present in an outermost p subshells are being shared during bonding process. Hence we get the oxidation state as a +1, whereas -5 is obtained due to the electronegativity, means the tendency to gain the electrons. Why they have a tendency to gain the electrons? In order to become stable. Now as they contains here, how many electrons in their outermost shell? 3 electrons. If they gain 5 electrons, they will complete their octet structure. So the electrons gain madidravu stable agirtav. Hence, because of which we have written the another oxidation state as -5 in order to maintain the stability, and +1 is formed due to the inert pair effect, that is NP1, where s orbitals, the electrons present in an s orbitals are not involved in the bonding process. Clear? So this is about the oxidation. So as we know, group 13 elements, they exhibit variable oxidation state. Out of those oxidation state, the group oxidation state of group 13 element is plus 3, whereas the other oxidation state shown by the group 13 elements are plus 1i minus 5. Now if we are going to study about these oxidation state, that is plus 3, plus 1i minus 5 shown by these elements, so we can state that here the plus 1 oxidation state is shown by only those elements which are undergoing inert pair effect. How the plus 1 yavag bartadandre adarvage inert pair effect aitandre s orbital participate madangilla bonding work ig nange helidri s orbital yavag participate madangilla bonding process vaga Now see, I will write here two configurations. What is the atomic number of gallium? What is the atomic number of gallium? Yeah, now I will write it as aluminium and gallium. Aluminium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1, 13. Clear? So in an electronic configuration we have written it as with noble gas 4 neon 3s2 3p1 atvadu gallium 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6 4s2 3d10 4p1 here this is written as argon ಆರ್ಗಾನ್ 4s2 3d10 4s2 4p1 ಅಂತ ಬರ್ದಿ ಈಗ ನಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ಮೈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ಇನರ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇನರ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ Yeah, here there is a presence of d orbital. The gallium hing irthadu. It is argon 3d10 orbital configuration 4s2 4p1 e form agadu. So now here it is a nucleus of an atom. So as there is a presence of an d orbital, it does not shield it and adanantra to protect madangilla. It has a poor screening effect. So, ಇದನ್ನು ಅದು ಇಗ್ನೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಮೋರ್ ಟೈಟ್ಲಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ ದಿ ರೀಸನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಬಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ಯಾ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ Due to the presence of an d orbital, there is a poor screening effect where s orbitals are being tightly held by the nucleus. Clear? So, means here the common thing is inert pair effect occurs when there is a presence of intervening d and f orbitals. D mat f orbitals ittantandra adruvage enagtada inert pair effect agtada. Now here the question is inert pair effect occurs in as we know there are 5 elements in our group 13 boron aluminium gallium indium and thallium out of these 5 where does the inert pair effect occurs in which elements gallium indium also because indium contains 4d10 next thallium work 4f 14 other 5d10 other clear means From gallium to thallium, as there is a presence of d and f orbitals, all these 3 elements they undergo inert pair effect. Andre ee muru vagu inert pair effect agate antandre alli en torustade plus 1 oxidation state compulsory bartade clear but plus 1 is not shown by boron aluminium why boron and aluminium does not exhibit plus 1 oxidation state because there is absence of d and f orbitals. Hence, they does not undergo inert-pair effect, means the stability of, now we are going to state that the stability of plus 1 oxidation state increases down the group. What does this statement tells us? Plus 1 oxidation state, yavag stable akun thuktadanta? Top to bottom muadan antandra, equation itandra. Boron matta thallium mulam. Plus 1 oxidation state, L is stable. Which element has a stable plus 1 oxidation state out of boron and thallium? Thallium. Yakandra, stability of plus 1 oxidation state, it increases. Color muadang, top to bottom muadang, other stability, HGA kon thukkud. Because top to bottom, as we move, there is an inert pair effect which is going to take place due to the presence of d and f orbitals. Clear? Now, out of, if the question is, out of gallium and indium, which has a stable plus 1 oxidation state? Gallium matha indium mulam. Indium it is. Na ili en barden? Top to bottom stability en akun thuktudu? Hechige akun thuktudu? Ik top to bottom andre ida order barthudu? Thallium. Ik ee order andre id kalagadu anta andre id stability idrkintanu hechige irthudu plus 1 mulam. Next, thallium. See, I will give an example here. ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಬರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಲಿ ಅಂತ ಬರೀತೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ನಾವು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ಇದ್ರ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಏನಿದೆ? ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಇದು ಮೈನಸ್ 1 ಇತ್ತು ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಮೈನಸ್ 1. ನೌ ಇಫ್ ಮೈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್, ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್? You will answer it as an indium chloride, because indium is more stable in its plus 1 oxidation state compared to the gallium. Gallium kintanu idu plus 1 olige en irthet anta bahal stable irthe. Idana yenan hing barde andre, now you will answer it as gallium. Because it is more stable in its plus 1 oxidation state than that of boron. So, always the stability of plus 1 oxidation state, it increases down the group, because top to bottom there is a more possibility of inert pair effect here. Now, which is an another oxidation state? It is in plus 3. The stability of plus 3 oxidation state it decreases down the group. Now, what does it mean? Top to bottom muadangi stability en aagthe plus 3 the decrease akond bartade. Ig nange idu top ig plus 3 yavaga bartade andre s matte p eradu involve aadu. Top to bottom yak decrease agate andre kalagiru anta elements olaga d matte f orbitals irtavu. D matte f orbitals idaga avu en martave, they will prevent the s orbital to participate in the bonding process. ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ನ ಬಿಡಂಗಿಲ್ಲವು, ಎಲೆ ಎದುರೊಳಗೆ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಅ ಕೇಸ್, ಟಾಪ್ ಟು ಬಾಟಮ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೆಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 3 ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 3 ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್? ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 3 ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್? ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ. Because it does, oxidation state doesn't matter with the atomic size exception which is occurring. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಿನ ಈಗ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಸೊ ಬೋರಾನ್, ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ, ಗ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ, ಇಂಡಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಥ್ಯಾಲಿಯಂ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1. ಟಾಪ್ ಟು ಬಾಟಮ್ ಏನಾಗಬೇಕು?
टॉप टू बॉटम इंक्रीज आगे
प्लस वन
प्लस थ्री ऐन आगे टॉप टू बॉटम डिक्रीज हकोत हो
अंदर बोरॉन ऐन प्लस थ्री वर्ग बहुत स्टेबल
सो माय क्वेश्चन वाज आउट ऑफ अल्युमिनियम एंड गैलियम विच इज मोर स्टेबल इन इट्स प्लस थ्री ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इट इज एन अल्युमिनियम बिकॉज डाउन द ग्रुप द प्लस थ्री ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इट गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग नाउ सी इफ आई राइट इट लाइक दिस व्हाट इज दिस अल्युमिनियम क्लोराइड गैलियम क्लोराइड आउट ऑफ दीज टू विच इज मोर स्टेबल या अल्युमिनियम क्लोराइड इज मोर स्टेबल वाई इट इज मोर स्टेबल बिकॉज अल्युमिनियम इज मोर स्टेबल इन इट्स प्लस थ्री ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट देन दैट ऑफ विथ गैलियम क्लियर अदर क्वेश्चन हिंग इतना I sorry, same I have written. Which is more stable here? BCl मत BCl3 वाला क्या out stable है? BCl3, yeah, it is stable. Why it is stable? Tell me. Yeah, इधर वाला boron में लेने दा plus three है दा, इलेने इतना दा plus one वाला इतना ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಯಾವತ್ತು ಪ್ಲಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಒಳಗೆ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇರ್ತದ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಒನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಡಿ ಮತ್ತು ಎಫ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಏನಾಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಇನರ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಥರ್ಟಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಸಾರಿ ಸರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೊ ರಫ್ಲಿ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ So it is boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, and thallium. Group oxidation state means all of them they will show plus. But plus one is shown by only gallium, indium, and thallium. Why? Yeah, because of presence of d and f orbital. Now again, all of them they have an ability to form another oxidation state, which is that minus five. Because all of them they require five electrons to complete their octet structure. Hence, they will show minus five oxidation state. Clear? This is about the physical properties of an group 30 elements. So it was electronic configuration, atomic size, next ionization energy, after the ionization energy it is electronegativity and finally it was the oxidation state. Okay, next. So our next is ಇದೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೇಳ್ದಂಗದೇನು ಅನಾಮಲಸ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಬೆರಿಲಿಯಂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿರಿಯಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಅನಾಮಲಸ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ನೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಮಿ ದಿ ಅನಾಮಲಸ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಮತ್ತು ಬೆರಿಲಿಯಂ ಈಗ ಬರ್ತೇವೆ ನಾ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅದ ಅದು ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಪಿ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಮುಗಿಯೋ ಮಟನು ಅದನ್ನ ಬರಿಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆದ್ದೆ Yeah, that is the first one. So anomalous behavior of boron is top to bottom. Iga group 13 anna neevu consider madidra boron first element idu. Boron size enu irutte evattu small irutte. Same thing lithium a group the first member. Lithium size enu irutte small. Same with an beryllium. So always top to bottom as the atomic size increases, the first elements they always have a smallest atomic size. So among the anomalous behavior of boron, boron has a
smallest atomic size. So as it has smallest atomic size, the electrons are more tightly held, means it requires more or less energy to remove outermost electron. So outermost electron tagya keen aagtade bhaala energy bekaagtade. So the energy which is required to remove the outermost electron is known as it is known as ionization energy. So our second point is boron has ionization energy. Okay. Now next, as we know its atomic size is small, boron size smaller than that. Now whether it has more or less attraction towards the incoming electron? When the atomic size is smaller, it is having more attraction towards the incoming electron. Size sanada itana electron self irthavanda. So ig now matta atomic electrons na add madidivi andre, if we given another electrons, the nucleus holds those electrons tightly, or the nucleus is having more attraction towards the incoming electron, so what happens to the electronegativity? Whether the electronegativity is more or less for a boron? More it is. So as boron has the smallest atomic size, it is more electronegativity. Now as you know, gallium, indium and thallium, now group 13 bage matladtene, gallium, indium and thallium has an d and f orbitals in it, okay. But when it is an aluminium, it doesn't has d orbital, but it contains vacant d orbital. Howda adr kade d orbital illa, but adr kade yen irthada empty d orbital antru idde irthada. But when it comes to the boron, whether boron has vacant d orbital? No. So our fourth anomalous behavior of a boron is there is a absence of or non-availability of the absence of vacant d orbitals. Adar kade yen illa, vacant d orbitals illa. Clear? So these are the four anomalous behaviors shown by the boron. Ig next after ee chapter the continuation and the group 14 start madadaga nammattal anomalous behavior of carbon bardaga hosad enalla. What it will be? Carbon is having smallest atomic size, carbon is having high ionization energy, carbon is more electronegative, and next it is there is absence of a vacant d orbital. Clear? It is more electronegative. Okay. So after the anomalous behavior of a boron, we are going to write some of the some of the properties of boron which differs with other elements. So now again we are going to study the properties of boron which are quite different from the other elements. Other elements means aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, which are present in their respective group itself. So here first point which we already know, we have studied in the in the introduction itself. What is that? Boron is a non-metal. Boron is a non-metal, while others are others are metals. Ig navu en bariyatevla, these properties are different from the respective elements which are present in the same group itself. So now boron is a non-metal while others are metals here. Next, as it is a non-metal, whether it conduct the electricity? No. So boron does not conduct electricity while others are good conductors. While others are good conductors. Now, as it is a non-metal, means most of the non-metals are hard in nature and they will be having high melting and boiling point. Now, same thing happens with an boron. As boron is a non-metal, boron is having high melting and boiling point compared to the others. So when it comes to the boron and aluminium, which will be having high melting and boiling point, it will be boron, because boron is a non-metal while others are the metals here. Clear? So first difference between the boron and the other elements are, boron is a non-metal and others are metal. Boron does not conduct electricity while others are good conductors of electricity. Next, boron is having high melting and boiling point while the others will be having low melting and boiling point. Clear? Next, the oxides of boron. Oxides of boron and rin. Oxides of boron. Now if I say oxides of carbon, carbon in the baruanta oxide, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. Oxides of boron means the oxide which is formed by boron, that is boron oxide. Oxides of aluminium, aluminium oxide. See ya? Okay, same thing. The boron, the oxides of boron. The oxides of boron are acidic in nature while others are amphoteric and basic in nature. Illodrile yen oxides form agirthavla. Oxides in three types were classified. Oxides can be classified into three types. Those are acidic oxide, basic oxide, and amphoteric oxide. Clear? Ignore relay. Acidic anate vantandra. Ad edir jati react aktiti, base jati react aktiti. Oxide edir jati react aktiti, base jati. As it is a basic, it will react with an acid. Then what is an amphoteric? It reacts with both acid and base, are known as amphoteric. Clear? Tilithinid nimga, acid antandra base jyothi react aktada, base antandra acid jyothi react aktada. But at amphoteric antandra, the enu irthada, of the acid jyothi nu react aktada, base jyothi nu react aktada. We consider water as an amphoteric in nature. Clear? Water acid jyothi nu react aktiti, base jyothi nu react aktiti. Adhika adhani yen anth karitara? Amphoteric antar. So, ik namgi group 13 var gain beka gudandra, boron adhu oxides yen irthav antha? Acidic irthav. But bare oxides yen irthad? Amphoteric ar irthad athva? Basic ar irthad. Clear? Next, what is an allotropy? Have you heard about the allotropes? We state that the allotrope of carbon are diamond and graphite. Thing and you know, allotropes and real. Same element exist in different physical forms. Appearance change irthiti, but element same irthiti. In an example here, phosphorus in adala, phosphorus element, it exists in three forms: red phosphor,
black phosphor and white phosphor.
Andra phosphor namaga moor form olak sigatit. One white aiti, one red adha, one black adha. Antandra nodak appearance in it adha different aiti. So in an allotropes the physical appearance will be different here. So same thing when it comes to in group 13 elements, boron forms, boron has two allotropic forms, that is antada boron yered wave work physical appearance different irthadu boron adu. It exists in two different allotropic forms, and the two different allotropic forms of boron are, one is crystalline form and the other is amorphous form. Clear? So idin boron adala nature olaga ear type olaga exist aagtittanthe. Ava ear type allotropes yavudu boron idu, one adu crystal form olaga irthiti, inondu amorphous. Amorphous is complete powder. Clear? Whereas as you know, crystals means the common salt which we use. Adu den texture irthadala, touch madidru hengu gothagutadala, adenada crystalline form idu. So here boron has only allotropic forms, while the other elements of in group 13 they does not forms allotropic forms. Clear? So this is about the some different behavior shown by the boron with the other elements, where boron is a non metal, others are metals. Boron is a boron does not conduct electricity, while others are the good conductors of electricity. Next, boron will be having high melting and boiling point compared to the other elements, where they have a low melting and boiling point over there. And the oxide of boron, that is boron oxide, is acidic in nature, while the others are amphoteric or basic in nature. What are amphoteric oxides now? Yeah, which react with both acid as well as base, are known as in amphoteric. Next, boron exists in two allotropic forms, and those two allotropic forms of boron are crystalline form and amorphous form. Then tell me, in how many allotropic forms does the phosphorus exist?
Three.
Which are those?
White, red
and black phosphorus. Clear? Physical appearance different. So this is about the anomalous behavior as the different properties of boron. So in our next class we have to start with the chemical properties of boron. So among the chemical properties of boron, again it is same as that of S block elements. Reaction with oxygen, yeah, reaction with water, reaction with halogen, reaction with nitrogen. Now tell me, if it is reaction with oxygen, they will form their respective oxides. If it is reaction with halogen, yeah, they form their respective halides. If it is with a nitrogen, what it is? Nitride. What is the formula of nitride? Andra bari N3 ant baradandra aitad nitride. Is it a nitride? Hogli basic ig hogun oxide. Formula of oxide, very good, O2, oxygen ad O2. Now oxide ad formula kelate nimge, what is the formula of oxide? Yeah, very good, it is O-2. Halide, yeah, X-1. Now tell me nitride. N? Yeah, N-3. Al mal irudu kalagi helibidtiri N3. O-2 irudu O2. Now another one, sulfide. Sulfide. Yeah, S-2. Clear? Common when it reacts with water. Reacts with water. Hydroxide. ಬರೇ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೇನು ಆಗ್ತದೆ? ವಾಟ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್, Yeah, there is a liberation of hydrogen gas. L out. S block na bit mund barudu. P block. So here, whenever it reacts with an water, always it forms a hydroxide with the liberation of an hydrogen gas. But when a compound reacts with an water, what we get? Compound reacts with an water. What happens when a compound reacts with an water? Slaked lime. Have you named the compound now? No. Then have you got the slaked lime over there? ನನ್ನ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಏನಂದ್ರ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆತಂದ್ರ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬರ್ತೈತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸು ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಒಳಗೆ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೋ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಲಿವ್ So in the next class, we will study about the chemical properties of a group 30. Okay?